We're in Hammond, of course. It's not a normal day, not a normal time for Fire Chief Daniel Foulks, but things are getting a little bit back to normal. Chief, how would you assess how things are in the Hammond area?
We're getting better, so we're getting some power restored. A lot of the debris is stacked up, starting to get picked up now by debris contractors. Most all the roads in the city of Hammond are cleared. We worked really hard after storm, making sure to get access to our citizens, firemen, policemen, city workers, even average citizens were out with chainsaws, making sure our roads get open. So things are starting to get back to normal. We're not there yet, but it's probably going to be a long road. We're still experiencing a high call volume here at the fire department. Before the storm, we were averaging about 15 calls a day. Right now, we're at 30. So we're double the call volume that we normally run on an everyday basis.
And I know you've had some fires.
Yes, we have had several fires, most of it is because of the storm. Generators, stuff like that. So, it's a higher call volume.
What advice then would you give to generator operators that maybe they don't know, and for that matter, people who are getting their electricity back?
Rule of 20 is the biggest thing. We've had a lot of carbon monoxide alarms. That has been the biggest issue that we've faced as far as generators are concerned. Carbon monoxide, it's a deadly gas. You can't smell it, you can't see it, and it seeps into your home. So we're asking folks to keep their generators 20 feet away from any opening. Have their exhaust pointed away from their residence. Don't put it in your garage. We understand the thing about security and stuff like that, but being secure is not going to do you any good if you don't wake up in the morning.
Because you don't smell the carbon monoxide, you don't know anything about it until it's too late.
Correct. And you won't even know it. You just won't wake up. And that people have carbon monoxide alarms in their house. They've been going off. We've been going out. Some people have just out of concern called us out to check their home out, and we have found high levels of carbon dioxide in residents. So we're encouraging folks to keep their generators away from their house. And the weird thing is even the whole house home standby generators have really caused an issue because they're in places where there's vents inside of the home. They're right next to the home and they run 24 hours a day. So that has become a big issue as well. People have realized that carbon monoxide still seeps into their home. Some of these homes, that's the only gas appliance they have is that whole home generator. And they don't have carbon monoxide detectors in their home. So if you have a whole home generator runs off of propane or natural gas, or even a small standby generator outside, go get a carbon monoxide detector. It's one of the best purchases, just like a smoke alarm.
Well, and of course, it would apply to gasoline generators, too.
Absolutely. Any generator that runs off of some type of fuel oil, combustible gas, you really need a carbon monoxide alarm in your house.
And you can get them very cheaply, too. I mean, I've known some air conditioning contractors that gave them away.
Absolutely. Just like smoke alarms, it's a very inexpensive purchase to save your life.
So what else are you firemen doing at this time? I mean, I know you're helping to give out materials.
Right. So we've been giving away tarps every morning. As many as we can get in, we give them out. Usually last about an hour to an hour and a half. Yesterday, we had six pallets of ice come in from a neighboring department in St. Tammany Parish. We gave that out as best we could. We got little to no notice on it. It just kind of showed up. So we just started throwing ice in people's vehicles.
One of the perspectives that I have from driving across the parish is that the damage, the effects of the storm are worse the farther south you go. Amite's better off than Hammond, but not as good as Kentwood, for example.
Correct. And I think if you drive through main roads of Hammond, you don't really see it. But when you get off into our neighborhoods, you can really tell the damage that was caused. There's a lot of folks out there that are hurting right now. A lot of people who have trees in their homes. Major debris. There were some folks that still they hadn't been able to cut their driveway out to even get their vehicles out. So, we're trying to help with that as best we can and to work within, the confines that we have as far as manpower and such. But it's really, and everybody's comparing, Katrina and all this, and I rode Katrina out and Hammond Central Fire Station, just like I rode Ida out and Katrina Ida actually seemed a lot worse than Katrina was. So the damage that I'm seeing is far worse than what we had to deal with Katrina. But, you know, as a whole, I think we're going to be okay. We're going to get through it and move on. And we're learning a lot of lessons. And, you know, hopefully the next storm, we're going to be even better than we were this time.
Chief, talking about fires that you have to fight, which there have been quite a few during this recovery period, I know that's why the burn ban is still in effect.
Yes, and it's real important, the burn ban, because everyone's out of power right now. So a lot of folks have their windows open, and there's a lot of folks out there who are very sensitive to smoke, a lot of our elderly folks who just can't deal with it, and it could cause major health issues for those folks and increase the demand on emergency services. So we're just asking people not to burn right now. Let's get power back, and you know, pile your debris out by the road. The parish is going to come through and pick it up rather than try to burn it. And I know that may be a little bit of extra burden, but it could save the life of one of our residents that are impacted. Also, inside the city limits of Hammond, burning is prohibited by city ordinance. So there's no burning at all. So just please refrain from burning right now. And it'll ease the burden on the fire department and help our citizens recover a little bit quicker.
You know, smoke is a deadly thing, and it's hard on people with allergies, with breathing problems, with asthma, you name it. I mean, it's not even being a good neighbor to burn.
Right. And that's all we're asking, is being good neighbors, taking care of one another. We're all in this together. We all have to stick together. So check on your neighbors. Be cognizant of something that you're doing that may impact your neighbor negatively. And just try to not to do it as much, and especially right now while the burn ban is on. Just refrain from doing that. There's going to be plenty of time for us to take care of that in the future. So let's just, you know, be a good neighbor right now.
Any other advice when it comes to debris, which is everybody's big concern right now?
Yeah, there's two things. We know everybody wants to get out in their yard and clean up. It is really hot right now. There's been days that we've had major heat advisories. Keep yourself hydrated. Take breaks often. You know, wear, you know, long sleeves, a shaded hat. Stuff like that to keep that heat stress from getting to you. That is a big deal. If you get overcome with heat, you know, you may have to go to the hospital. Right now, our hospitals are overloaded because of COVID. So we need to make sure that we're taking care of ourselves every day. And then also, when you're stacking these debris piles up, be cognizant of your children. You know, don't let them go play on a debris pile. As things dry out, as things die, they may become unstable. We don't want to have any kids injured because they were playing on a debris pile and got trapped underneath something. Also, there's still a lot of down power lines. You know, treat them as live and energized. Energy is bringing our grid up a little bit at a time. But there may be some lines out there that are backfeeding from an improperly wired generator. So please stay away from those lines as best you can. Keep your kids away. Keep an eye on them. We don't want to have to come out and take care of somebody that's electrocuted or overcome with heat when it could have been prevented.